Hello, now we enter to the second act. I hope that you have enjoyed the first act of The Loom. All the areas that we discussed, now we come to Cyprus. We are transported from Venice to Cyprus. And what is going to happen now, we will look. Act 2, Scene 1, a seaport in Cyprus, an open place near Key. That word is pronounced as Key, not Quay. People mispronounce Quay, but that's Key in British English. Means a port or wharf. Here, some insignificant characters coming, and you know, in Shakespeare, all dramas, once a serious characters talk, they will produce a certain parallelism and what is called an exploration of imagination. That is true in written in blank words. So it is very easy to identify when insignificant characters speak. They naturally speak in prose. So once we get insignificant characters, we can easily avoid them and skip. And once we reach significant characters or like heroes and heroines, we should be very careful. That is the practice of all tragedies, that you, once you come to postgraduate classes, you will see that. Now here, the total atmosphere that you find, Othello in a particular ship has been sent, Cassio in another ship has been sent to Cyprus, and followed by our Desdemona and Emilia and other crew members in different ships. They are destination to reach Cyprus, and their mission, Othello's mission as a general, mission is given to devastate Turkish people, Ottoman Turk, those who are becoming very threatening force to Cyprus and Venice. And what is going to happen? Now you see Montano, enter Montano with two other gentlemen. Montano is not that much very significant character. What from the Cape can you discern at sea? Montano asking, has there any information from the sea? I mean, whether any new ship has arrived. What from the Cape and discern at sea? Cape means the wharf and the quay, I mean port place where ships are landing. First gentleman, nothing at all. It is a high road flat. What is to say, middle lord? His two gentlemen, other gentlemen of the court, are reporting Montano. Oh, very, very dangerous situation, my lord, because very huge and tumultuous turmoil type of wind in the ship, in the sea. And I don't think any ship can easily survive. So, no information so far we got that the ship has arrived. I cannot twix the haven and the main, our desire or sail. It is a heavy, just like a tsunami, what you call, you have seen in your life, a tsunami coming from the sea, like a very huge waves, depending on the threatening force of the wind. And this is a very dangerous situation. To overcome these very elephantine type of waves and to reach the waves of wharf of Cyprus. Is reported between the haven and the main. Main means sea. I mean, it is a very huge turmoil type of aggravated type of a journey that from the sea level to the heaven. Heaven means sky. So all the waves are going and going to up to the sky. In this sky, this type of tumultuous situation, journey in a ship is very difficult, my lord. Descry on a sea that you see, you just watch there, no ship coming. Descry, see. ఉంటాను మీ థింగ్స్ ద విండ్ డస్ స్పీక్ అలౌడ్ ఎట్ ల్యాండ్ మీ థింగ్స్ ఐ థింక్ విండ్ ఐ మీన్ నవ్ డేస్ స్టోమ్ లైక్ తుఫాన్ టైప్ విండ్ హ్యాస్ కమ్ ఫుల్లెస్ట్ బ్లాస్ట్ నెవర్ షుక్ ఆన్ ఏ బ్యాటిల్మెంట్ ఆల్ ద బ్యాటిల్మెంట్స్ మీన్ ఆల్ ద వాల్స్ ఆఫ్ ద సీస్ ఆర్ డిస్ట్రాయిడ్ బై ద విండ్ అండ్ బర్స్టింగ్ బ్లాస్ట్ టైప్ ఆఫ్ స్టోమ్స్ If it is rough wind, so up on the sea. If it is going like this, no ship will arrive here, I think. Our Mundano's reports. If it is rough wind up on the sea, what ribs of the oak with huge mountains melt can hold the mortise? These ships will be totally devastated or destroyed. I think such a huge wind and storm I have never seen in my life. What shall we hear of this? There is a sound coming. What shall we hear of this? Second gentleman. A segregation of the Turkish fleet, dispersal of a Turkish fleet, would but stand upon the banning shore. The chiding billows seems to pelt and the clouds that wind shake the surge with a high monstrous mane. Even it is reported some Turkish ships are going back because of the tumultuous situation. Of the sea. So, on the one hand, we anticipate Othello as a general and other ships on the other side. But our enemies are totally destroyed almost by the sea's enragement. Seems to cast water burning bear and quench the gods of ever fixed pole. I never did like a molestation view, molestation disturbance on the enchafed flood. As a gentleman, as a man to report you, I cannot watch and I cannot see any ships because of the size of the waves are very, very, very high so that I cannot see. Mundano, if that Turkish fleet be not unsheltered, embayed, they are drowned. All right, if some ships are seen coming and you report they are Turkish people ships, that should not be allowed to enter here. We cannot give them permission. We have to disembark them. Molestation soon. Be not unsheltered. You do not give shelter to such enemies. And so they should be sent back. If it is impossible, they bear it. No, this time a gentleman arrives. A third gentleman. So two gentlemen reporting to Mundano. Now finish. Now third gentleman arrives. News, lords. News. Your wars are done. Underline. Now third gentleman reporting that, oh my lord, our country has won. Means what? Our wars are finished. The desperate tempest hath banged on the Turk. This one side, our ships are attacking them. At the same time, a tumultuous waves now almost damaged Turkish ships. So they cannot easily enter to our country. Now, we are one. We have succeeded in our war, reported by third gentleman. That they are designment holes. Designment means what? All the plans Turkish people had, everything disintegrated. Disintegrated means destroyed. Destroyed means what? Devastated. Devastated means what? Spoiled. Spoiled means what? Become irrelevant. Irrelevant means what? Everything lost, my lord. Everything lost. What is there? Nothing to worry, we have won the war, my lord, reported to Mundano. Now see, all the designment holds, another ship of Venice. Now underline, another ship of Venice. It is reported another one ship has arrived from Venice. Means that you know in 3 to 4 ships they have started journey to destination Cyprus. So one is, you know, the low end group, second one is Casio in group, third one Desdemona in group. They are in our basis they all right started from Venice. One of the ship that has arrived hath seen a grievous wreck and sufferance. One of the ships, my lord, reported that started from Venice has become a wreck, almost a wreck means destroyed, I think. And they feel sufferance. Sufferance means almost ruining, almost destroying. They find certain tumults, all right, bigger waves, and they cannot control themselves. Most part of the fleet wrecked. Almost most part of the ship. One of the ships, whose ship not reported. One of the ships that started from Venice to our country, Venice to Cyprus, now reported to be almost finished. How is it true? No, am I to believe this? Whose ship is that? Third gentleman, this ship is here put in at Varnosia, Michael Casio, underline. One of the ship that the ship has entered the harbor here. One of the ship that almost destroyed has reached our harbor here. It is kind of a ship known as Veronica, underline Veronica. Veronica is a ship equipped by Verona. So this Veronica, the ship's name is Veronica. And possessed by Michael Casio, now almost a wreck and reached here, most of the part. The ship here put in is Veronica, and Michael Casio, lieutenant to the warlike Murudello. That we are very thorough with our Casio, who is the pilot to the lost ship, now almost reached, and he is the present lieutenant to Othello as a general. He is come ashore the Moor himself at sea, underline Moor. And you have to remember Othello still now in the middle of the sea, not reaching. He is now there in the middle of the sea. The Moor himself at sea and is full of commission here for Cyprus. Commission full of pieces of information, full of commission. He has come that change the Cyprus, the governor on Mudello. The Moor himself on the sea is the way and under orders to take of charges Cyprus. He is going to come sometime within short time. He will reach here. After reaching here, he will take the charge of our place. I am glad on it, the worthy governor. Mondano has a very big opinion on Othello as a general. All right, I am very happy. Let him come and take the charge of this country. Okay, I am very happy. I have a very good opinion about him. He is a very bold and courageous and audacious governor. Third gentleman, but the same Casio, though he speak of comfort touching the Turkish laws, yet the looks sadly. Our Casio now reached here, he looks very gloomy, he looks very sad. It is reported Turkish all the ships now almost returned back and some destroyed in the sea. But he is not happy. I think he looks very sad. Why? Praise the Moor, be safe. Probably he is thinking about governor. I mean general Moor, our blackish Moor Othello in the sea. That may be the reason he is very sad. For they were parted with foul and violent tempest. Probably when they start their journey together, a very big wave and a very big storm might have separated them. And knowing the real truth, whether Moor is alive or not, may be the reason why he is sad. So I don't know. On the one hand, Turkish people returned and destroyed and they stopped the war. Man should be very happy, but our Casio, who has a commission reached here as a lieutenant to governor, and he looks very sad, my lord. मुंडे प्रे हेवन हि बी लेट हिम लेट गॉड गिव हिम पीस फॉर आई हैव सर्व्ड हिम ऑल राइट ओथेलो इज ए गुड मैन ओथेलो इज ए गुड जनरल ओथेलो इज ए होनेस्टी मैन सो आई हैव सर्व्ड हिम इन डिफरेंट डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस आई नो हिम पर्सनली इज ए वेरी नाइस मैन द मैन कमांड्स लाइक ए फुल सोल्जर underline full soldier all right once he is a soldier that is the code of profession all right once suppose you are a what do you call a district collector district collector should be a district collector once you become a police officer should be a police officer there not need not to be a time that a police officer wearing all the uniform going to the junction and telling that I am the circuit inspector of this police station no need people should gradually know that he is a police officer all right not by telling and reporting once you are not really holding the position holding the real role people will begin to poo-poo you mean to fool make you foolish so he says I know Othello I know general he is 100% general 100% perfect 100% what do you call he is a good soldier I know just like how many of you can very boldly say that you are 100% a student 100% a son 100% a daughter just like we I mean our Montano says he is 100% perfect in what in soldiership he is a 100% big soldier like that in every profession once you join you should be 100% a professional just like 100% in your life just like a teacher should be 100% a teacher a professor should be 100% a professor a police officer is 100% a policeman in the same way I know Othello there is no other way to criticize he is 100% perfect soldier I know let us the seaside who as well to the vessel that coring throw out of your eyes brave Othello underline brave Othello he is not a simple man he is not a simple man to be child enough to be made afraid of these waves are not these waves are nothing before him because he is just like a giant and audacious person brave Othello even till the man to the mean that aerial blue let the sky be overcome with waves in the sea no problem for Othello I know him his courage is his honesty he is brave audacious all these qualities are there he is 100% a big soldier perfect soldier even till with the main means to see aerial blue let the sea reach the sky no problem let the waves reach the sky no problem for him because he has seen so many waves and so many battles and fully 100% experienced man in the war so it is nothing for him he won't be damaged or destroyed anywhere he will come back I am 200% guaranteeing you that he will come back. You become ready to receive him. The indistinct regard, third gentleman, come, let's do so. For every minute is expectancy. Underline expectancy. Expectancy. We should expect our general. We should render him a warm welcome. So let us prepare ourselves. How to receive our general in Cyprus let us our expense more of the arrivals mean ships arriving we shall expect any moment their ships will arrive in our quay in our wharf so that we can render them a warm welcome dear this time Cassio now is a commission who is the lieutenant to our other law, whose ship almost damaged and reached the war for port, now entering the stage. Enter KSU. Thanks to the valiant of the Swarthy Isle, to the Sparrow, the Moor, let the heavens give him defense against their elements. Let the people come almost. Our Moor is coming. We will give him all the elements and powers, for I have lost him on the dangerous sea. As Mondano reports, Cassie also reporting that, though Othello has been separated from me by the big waves of the sea, I know dangerous sea could do anything him, he will come back. I lost him in the dangerous sea. There were a lot of things in the sea, big waves and the storms, that separated Othello from Cassio in a different route. Nothing to worry. Is he well shipped? Mondano wondering. I hope his ship is very strong, right? Well shipped means very strong. It is not old age very, very old ship. That is very strong. Am I to think that very strong? Cassio, his box it stoutly timbered, his pilot, all the box, all the logs by which a ship has been made, very strong, that I know. His pilot and a very expert and approved allowance, therefore my hopes, not suffered to death, stand bold and cure. Definitely, his ship is very strong. Not only his ship is strong, his willpower is very strong. Those people who are in his ship are also strong. There is no worry about to think that something would happen. He will come back. This time, a very big voice, A-sail, 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 means ship has come. Enter messenger, Cassio asking, what noise going on there? What problem going on there? The town is, messenger, the town is empty and the broad to the sea. Stand ranks of people, they cry a sail in front of the quay, in front of the wharf and in front of the port. People say, sail has come, sail has come, sail has come. Means what? A ship newly arrived. A ship newly, all people tell a sail, a sail, a sail. Cassio, my hopes do shape him for the governor. Cassio telling, sometime our general has reached, our beauty, our ever lovable Othello general has arrived. At the same time in the wharf, it is a courtesy of the country to receive general with a high shot to the sky, just like a cannon would put, what you call pirangi tomb. That is a symbol of receiving the general a shot. Second gentleman, they do discharge of short courtesy, underline short courtesy, just like when we bury our socially cultured eminent people, all right, we police people will put fire into the sky in the same way. To receive such a governor general, all the people will be receiving in this way. My hopes do shape him for the governor. Or people say, short of courtesy, our friend at last. Our friend means almost they thorough with Othello is coming. I pray you go forth, Cassio. Cassio has also power. Cassio is lieutenant. Cassio reporting. I pray you, sir, go forth and give us the truth. Give forth. I tell you, I request you. Some of you go and get me correct information whether our governor general, our general Othello has arrived. It is the time of arrival. Second gentleman. I shall tell him. Mondano, but good lieutenant, is your general wived? Underline, is your general wived? Wived means Why would it mean? Hey, Mondano wants to ask Cassio, you, our general, is he married? Why would it mean married? Does he get a wife? In order to make more arrangement for this, comforts and conveniences. Mondano asking Cassio, is our general married? Why would Cassio, most fortunately, he hath achieved a maid. Yes, in 100%, he has achieved means obtained a maid. A maid. Maid means unmarried, primary, primrose flower like a girl. He has newly married a girl who has a very tender heart. She is very maid. That paragons describes. Paragons means no description. What is to say? How to describe such a pestilent beauty girl from the world? He has married a very beautiful girl who has no words to describe. Look. No, that such beautiful girls are presented in Shakespearean dramas. All right, wherever you go to, particular in tragedies, you will get such girls. I go to Olivia, all right, in Twelfth Night as a romantic comedy. Then Imogen in Tempest. Then you go to our Hamlet. We find in the same time Macbeth or Antony and Cleopatra. Or such, in all the serious plays, he has presented beautiful girls. All right. So that you have to remember here, Cassio as a lieutenant telling that no words to describe such a beautiful girl he has married. And one of the excels keys of blazoning pens. Cassio's another description. My lord, I should say, in the world, no pens can describe her. Look, such a pestilent beauty. ഒരു എഴുത്തുകാരനും ഒരു പേന കൊണ്ടും ഒരു തരത്തിലും വിവരിക്കാൻ കഴിയാത്തത്ര മാത്രമുള്ള സൗന്ദര്യ ദാമത്തെയാണ് മൈ ജനറൽ ഹാസ് മാരീഡ്. നോ പെൻസ് ക്യാൻ ഡിസ്ക്രൈബ് സച്ച് എ ബ്യൂട്ടിഫുൾ ഡിസ്ക്രിപ്ഷൻ. ഈ ലോകത്ത് ആർക്കും ചിത്രകാരനും അല്ലെങ്കിൽ എഴുത്തുകാരനും ഒരു പേന കൊണ്ടും അവളുടെ സൗന്ദര്യത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് വർണ്ണിക്കാൻ കഴിയില്ല. ഐ എം ഷുവർ, 100% ഷുവർ. സച്ച് നോ പെൻസ് ക്യാൻ സർ. Blazoning pens in the essential virtue of creation, destroyer of an ignore the qualities. What qualities? No negative quality attributed to Desdemona, only positive. So all the qualities cannot be described by any pens that found in the world. Such a beautiful girl, my Othello, my general, your general, governor of Cyprus has married. Now she is also coming here. I think in another ship coming. Let us wait and see. And what is going to happen? Let us see. Let us wait and see in the next class. Thank you.